Now, Kieran Roach back. My thanks to John Hurley from Cork, who no doubt did a much better job than I could have done on the men's over 40, which was a really exciting final. We have an interesting final coming up now with Nigel Payton against his much older brother, Ronan. Ronan asked me to point out that he's 3 years older, so at a serious disadvantage. And on a personal note, I hope Mossy are still listening. And welcome Henry Payton and the Payton family in Skerries. It's lovely to sit there and watch your two sons playing the final of the Leinster. Over 35 final. Brian Williams is the referee. Ronan has Ireland on his back. And Nigel hits the ball much harder than Ronan. This is a lovely drop from Ronan. That's really interesting. This total contrast in styles here, which is what I like. Nigel, the caller, with not with Ireland on his back, as the number one seed. Ronan came in with a number three seed. Nigel plays in Fitzwilliam Club here. Ronan plays out of Sutton. Oh, that's unlucky for Ronan. Those of you who aren't used to squash, just listen to the noise of the ball and you'll hear the crack when Nigel really strikes it. He gets enormous power out of the strike of the ball. I've often had the thought that, oh my goodness, Nigel, what did you do there? I always thought that we should get the noise of Aikman society out when Roland's playing, when Nigel's playing, because he hits the ball so hard. You get the crack out of the ball.
And one off. Great. What do you think it is? Two off. Two off. Two off. Two off. Is this point a rally?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. Not again.
That's too odd. It's funny because it's also understandable. Brian Williams, referee, has been reffing matches all day here, and the other courts, the 45s and upwards, play a system called pointer rally. So I'm getting it wrong now. Hand in, hand out, so that you don't get a point when you only get score a point when you're serving. In the over 35s and 40s, they play pointer rally. So every point you win, you actually get credit for it. And every point you lose, you get docked for it. Two totally different systems of scoring. And just for those who may not understand, part of the reason for that is that squash games were going on too long at top level. And they changed from hand in, hand out, up to 9, to a pointer rally, up to 11. There's still a lot of discussion going on about it, but at 35 and 40 level, oh, Ronan, that's a really bad drop. Very untypical of him, because he's got a beautiful control. 4-2. In a situation like that where Ronan had served. The score was stated 2-2, but Sarah would have gone to Nava. Now it's four to three. And Nigel gets the point. 3-4 now. Even though I've been commentating on the two different scoring systems, and they get confused. Nigel isn't happy with himself. Just thinking there, well, this rally went on and on and on. How comfortable Nigel is with those rallying. Roland's more inclined to end the rally and go for a winning shot. That's a lovely drop. He's got lovely grace on top of the bottom. Apologizes for hurting his older brother. Basically, the situation there is that he's hitting the sidewall and then into the front wall. And that's just the let. He's going for the front wall and it hits your opponent. It's a stroke. Against anyone else, Nigel would have looked for a stroke there, but against his big brother, he plays it. That brother plays exactly the same shot that Nigel played. That was lovely. And they both compliment each other. That was nice. Isn't brotherly love still alive in the personal household anyway? Long may it last is the thought I have.
Stand on five.
I know Henry's children are much better behaved than that. Oh, that's a lovely drop. Nigel did well to get it, but he couldn't get it up. 8-5. I think if Roland have any chance, he'd have to win the first game. That's another lovely drop post.
9-5, right.
9-5. An interesting point in the match.
So, 10-5, game ball.
Actually, in general, Nigel is very unreactive to the referee's decisions. He just hears it and plays on. Oh, Nigel, that was a poor play. I think he sort of knew that game was gone beyond him anyway. So, blood to the older brother. They actually make a complete difference in the way they play. It wasn't that as obvious in that game. But I would think Nigel would have been much more, not aggressive, just would be hitting the ball harder and not breaking the game up as much as Ronan allowed him, as he allowed Ronan to do that time. An interesting point there. Nigel just hitting the ball and it rolled out of court. Nigel just rolled it back on. The ball doesn't leave the court, actually. While the game is in play. So, I expect myself that Nigel will just put more power on the ball. And more consistent power. As Ronan is just such a lovely touch player, plays lovely bolts and drops. So you try and break up the game and not get into the long up and down the wall rallies that Nigel so loves. 15 seconds. And captaining the Ireland over 35 team in May. I think it was Nottingham. Nigel is a full Irish international. Ronan has played. Oh, he was also on the same Irish team and the Masters team. So Ronan leads one game to another one. Nigel's trademark, stepping in early and driving it hard and crisp and deep. Oh, lovely job, Nigel. A lot of people comment that Nigel has never developed a short game, the both and dropping game, and that he'd be better for it, but it has worked superbly well.
3-0
an early lead. And you notice he's putting much more power and more pace on the ball. Look at that beautiful forehand he has.
Yes, lad. 3-0.
I think Roland thought he might have got a stroke, but I don't think so. That's a lovely drop, Nigel.
Four love.
A lovely height on that. That Ronan didn't hit that one. Referee gives a let and they start all over again. Oh, I didn't think he was going to get a let for that one.
Five.
Yeah, Nigel is not playing sharp at all now. Everything is just being driven power and pace. I think Ronan will probably coast the rest of this game because he realizes it's fairly well gone past him and gone beyond him. It'll be very hard to come back from that. 2-6. 4-point gap. Very considerable. Ronan had a very hard 5-setter this morning against Kevin Moore. Ah, look at that. It's just lovely.
And out. 7-2.
I don't know what Nigel's score was this morning. But I think he would have been playing. Oh, it was Kevin Knox when I was playing. We've been Kevin Moore. But all the lads are playing very different with Nigel's pace and power. 9-2. That's a great
10-2 game
line that he was able to create on that backhand. 10-2. Yeah, as I thought, Ronan is on the bad six, he's just looking at trying to figure out how he could play. Oh, lovely drop. Beautiful drop.
And figure out how 3-10, he could game
play
ball.
The next game. Still a game ball. 3-10. Ah, lovely. So, one game on. And Nigel, the number one seed, really demonstrating his control. Just called 15 seconds. Get the lads back on court.
Game
hold. in the latter years, the two lads haven't played against each other all that much, being in different clubs and that.
Just left. No ball.
Actually, I always say Nigel doesn't have a real drop game, but he actually has a lovely touch on that backhand, where he just reaches in and takes all the pace off it. And it's very difficult, and even when you reach it, to generate pace. It's a great shot, Ronald. As Nigel acknowledges, but again, the amount of running Ronald was doing relative to Nigel. Again, a very nice drop from Nigel. Ronan got to it, but he didn't bring out the height to get over 2-1. That's a lovely shot from Nolan. A lovely flick of the wrist to generate the height. He didn't have time to get back out of an awkward position. Sergeant knew that was coming. Oh, I could just see that power forehand was coming.
3-1.
I noticed Nigel has changed his shirt. Nolan hasn't. Oh, I look wrong. That's probably because Nigel's wife is in a better situation for doing the laundry than Roman's, and she's expecting another child in about 2 weeks' time, so we have to minimize the laundry and save the washing machine. It'll be needed in a few weeks. Excuse for not beating his brother. I really thought if they'd had the shot 2 weeks ago and he's sleepless nights, he's a better excuse. Not sure about that pickup, Nigel. Oh. Nigel and Ronan don't have a problem with it, so why should I? Nigel's really just like a metronome. It's just power, power, power. And then the odd deft touch. Roland's all the time trying to create little subtle angles. Ah, yes. Again, he had his older brother going to the right and the ball went to the left. Nice, Arona.
2-7.
Ah, lovely drop, Nigel. As he gets control of the game, he's able to express his. Let's touch game a little bit better. like that, though, Nigel.
3-8.
3-8. Oh, that's just a lovely drop. Nigel was looking for that in a very nice way. Probably didn't expect to get it. But there's no harm in asking. That's a nice shot, Ronald.
5-8.
Still a gaping chasm between them on the first. That's a brilliant recovery. Oh. Nigel, his big brother. Older brother here. As a way of apology. Take that pain with my apology. Then he smiles at him. 9-5. Hard luck, Ronan. He had a long way to go around his brother.
10-5,
game ball. Nigel shakes his head at that. 6-10. Okay, 11-6. So Nigel's really well in control.
Nigel Lee, 2-1, the ball.
No. Nigel leads 2-1. And just for housekeeping, the match coming up after two on at 5:30. Probably about half an hour late at this stage, it was Jerry Callanan against Sean McKee. Jerry from Petrillium, Sean McKee from Belfast. Nigel, Roland thought he got should have got a stroke there. That game will follow this one immediately after. And following that, we have John Dineen from Cork and Mark Alex from Belfast in the over 55 final. And the proceedings will finish with a 7 o'clock scheduled game between Seamus Daly and Johnny Donovan. So that's our programme that's ahead for this live streaming of the Leinster Open. We'll return to the Peyton versus Peyton. Sounds like a court case, doesn't it? Oh, beautiful shot. Absolutely beautiful, Nigel.
True love.
True love. True love. Yeah. People have said it's not what Nigel does in one individual shot, it's just his relentless way of playing that just eats the confidence out of you. Needs the energy out of you, and you just know you're going forever. Oh, and Roland Hardluck, Roland tried to play very fancy. Flick with his backhand, using a lot of wrist, just didn't work. I know Roland had a very hard five setter this morning. Not the preparation you want to be facing your younger baby brother. Oh, very clever, Roland. Well done. Nigel taps his racket in acknowledgement. It's nice to see there's love lost between these two brothers. Very much out of played their dad a fair few times and enjoyed not only playing him but his company. A nice man for a policeman. And he'll kill me for saying that. 5-2. Nigel looks at the racket as if the racket was the fault. There's only a momentary irritation because he pulls that backhand drive out. With very little back lift, he generates a huge amount of power. Both forehand and backhand. And 7-3. That's unlucky for Roland. You notice Nigel gets on forehand. He's there so early that he can hold the racket and then generate tremendous power in his drive. Oh, that's unlucky, Roland. Trouble is you're forced into playing high risk shots. I wonder if they're going to come off. 10-3, match ball. I hope the family have enjoyed it. I hope they've enjoyed Ronan and Nigel playing. As they thank referee Brian Williams, I acknowledge the crowd. And what we knew from the start, we'd have a Peyton winner of the Leinster
bike type thing.
Over 35s. So it's younger brother Nigel beating Ronan 3-1. And I hope the Payton family don't just switch off now, because maybe there's nobody else listening to me and I'll end up talking to myself.